It's time for Back It From China!
Guten Tag, Leute van de YouTube. Welkom op mijn kanaal Wicked Gamer und Collector. Heute mag mij veel spaß. En dit is een review about a pocket game from our friends from China. But what's the main difference between this one and the other handhelds? It's very simple. This one is made to play original Mega Drive games on the go. Looks like a Sega Nomad, that kind of idea. Only our friends from China made something very nice. So, it comes with a power supply that will connect with an USB. So, what I really like about it, because you can use every USB power charger for the thing. Yeah, TV out cable. And manual in Spanish language, if I'm correct. And there is no English at all. So for me or for other people, it's useless. Or you can understand the language, of course. The console itself. It's got a 6-button layout. And I must say the D-pad is not bad at all. It feels really nice. A power and a reset button. So for resetting when you want to go back to the main menu. Yup. Here's a connector for plugging in original games. So let's turn it on and see what we're going to get with this little handheld. So what makes this portable system extra wicked? I know, because it has 68 built-in games. And no, not only crappy games, it got some good titles. Street of Rage, Sonic, Michael Jackson, and even Fist of the North Star. Well, must say, really cool. Of course, missing out some good titles, but we cannot have everything. Oh yeah, let's try out Street Race or Bare Knuckle. So let's listen closely to the music. Sounds not bad at all. And I hope you can see it on the camera. And the screen is pretty nice. Okay, let's game. Oh yeah, Sunset Riders. Really love this game. If you listen closely, the music's not like the original one. If you really don't know how the original sounds, check in the soundtrack from YouTube. Just search for it and you will hear it. Check out this one. This is pretty weird. If you start up a game, it doesn't have a title screen or any decals. It just start up in the game. First level. Sounds is not best I have heard, but as you can see, the gameplay is pretty good. No lack of problem at all. Let's try out the original game, and we can try how it fits in the original console. And this one is pretty tight. You need to press it very hard to make a good contact. I must say, I've cleaned this cartridge. If you have old cartridges, it can have some problems. So all my cartridge has been cleaned so far, I knew. Alright, let's start up the game. Yeah, it sounds the same. So the game that is on the system itself is pretty good. Pretty authentic like the original one. So, okay, let's try out the new game. Oh, and I want to mention something, and this is a pretty epic fail. The Super 1-on-12-1, the Chinese multi-card with a really awesome game on it. Alright, check this out. If you plug it in, and I tried it with both cards, you power on the system. It doesn't work at all. So that is a big, big disappointment. So you cannot use the Chinese multi-cards, the 1-on-12-1, of course. In the future, I really love to make an update video about it and try out the EverDrives from Crits and the Chinese version. So, and now the next test. Does it work with NTCS original Sega Mega Drive cards? And again, nope. It is not region free. Man, I really hate it. So, let's power it on the Sonic and Knuckles. Oh yeah, I really love this game. It works perfectly. Alright. And now, the final test. The test of the test. We're going to plug in Sonic 3. let's stick it in. Oh yeah. And really love these original cartridges. It's time to blow. Yep, I'm back. And blowing always does the trick. Of course you can clean it, but yeah, need to clean it again. And that's the question. Does it freeze? No, wobbling the control. Huh. And that is what I noticed about it. It's so tight that it fits the range of cards is so good that even when you wiggle it a little bit, there's no problem. Yeah, and listen closely to the sound. Ooh, it hurt my ears. Ooh. Yeah, wicked, it works. I almost forgot the ultimate test. Does it work with Sonic Mania? Yeah, does it work? Yeah, does it work? Ooh, it's a disappointment again. And does it work with Sonic Mania? So, it's time for some gameplay on the television. And if you're moving it a little bit around, you see some problem with the screen. But overall, if you play it and move the handheld around, it will be not a problem. So, enjoy the movie, and here are some gameplay of the games that are built in this system. So that completes the tour, the gameplay, the review and unboxing of this wicked portable system. I really love it. Overall, it is nice, it works good. The D-pad, everything feels very responsive, so it's just playing on the original Mega Drive. It got a TV out. Yeah, and also it's easy to plug in and play some games. It got built-in games. Not the best titles, but some good titles. And yeah, it's fun to have. It's a shame the 1/12 and 1 multi-card or the NTCS version games doesn't work. It has a region PAL lock. It's a shame, but I think even for this, it's a really good option if you want to play your games on the go. The original Sega Nomad is hard to find, very expensive, and even you want to have it with an LCD mod, and I can recommend it. I can recommend it to you. I have made a video about it, so check it. I will drop a link in the description for that one. Overall, it's a nice system. It is not very expensive. I don't know where they sell it for, but I think around the $50 you can find pick a portable system like this. And yep, overall, I can recommend it. It's a really awesome product from China. And the sound is not the best you can get, but okay. There are always some things I can find of a portable system that are not that good, like an original. But for the price and the money, job well done. Oh yeah. I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget to share my videos, subscribe my channel and leave a comment. What do you think of it? Do you want one? Or did you buy one? And I really love to know what do you think of it. Don't forget, stay strong, stay positive and stay wicked.
I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. And you can follow me on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. Thank you, comrade.